trouble, friends, with a wave of my hand, this very hand.
Please observe him, if you will. He's Professor Harold Hill, and I'm his assistant.
Bad kid, organized crime city boys.
Bad boys, bad
boys. Yes, you got trouble, my friend. Right here, I say trouble right here in River City. Why, sure, I'm a belly player. Certainly mighty proud to say it. I consider that the hours I spend with a cue in my hand are golden.
Help you cultivate horse sense and a cool head and a keen eye. Did you ever take and try to give an ironclad leave to yourself from a three-rail billiard shop?
But just as they say it takes judgment, brains, and maturity to score in a ball-playing game, I say that any boo can take and shove a ball in a pocket.
And we call that sloth, the first big step on the road to the depths of degrade. I say first it's a little medicinal wine from a teaspoon,
then beer from a bottle.
And the next thing you know, you boys is playing for money in a fishback suit.
And listening to some big out-of-town Jasper, hearing him tell about horse race gambling.
Not a wholesome trotting race, no, but a race where they sit right down on the horse.
Like to see some stuck-up jockey boy sitting on Dan Patch. Make your blood boil.
Well, I should say.
Now, friends, let me tell you what we mean. You got one, two, three, four, five, six pockets in the paper. Pockets that mark the difference between a gentleman and a bum. With a capital B and that rhymes with P and that stands for poo. What kind of conversation goes on while you're loafing around the hall?
You'll be trying out people.
Trying out Cubans.
Trying out tailor-mades like cigarette peels.
And bragging all about how you're gonna cover up a telltale breath with sensin.
One fine night, they leave the pool hall, headed for the dance at the armory. Libertine men and scarlet women and ragtime.
Oh, shameless music.
They'll drag your son and your daughter to the arms of a jungle animal instinct.
Mass. The devil's playground.
Trouble, we got trouble right here in River City.
Mothers of River City, heed the warning before it's too late. Watch for the telltale signs of corruption. The minute your son leaves the house, does he rebuckle his knickerbockers below the knee?
Is there a nicotine stain on his index finger? A dime novel hidden in the corn crib? Is he starting to memorize jokes from Captain Billy's whiz bang?
Are certain words creeping into his conversation? Words like swell.
And so's your old man.
If